This video will introduce the idea of limits through some graphs and examples. When I worked in San Francisco, I used to eat at Julia's Sushi and Salad Bar that had an interesting price structure. The food there cost $10 a pound, but if you happened to load up your plate to exactly 1 pound, you got a free lunch. So let's let y equals f of x represent the price of your lunch in dollars as a function of its weight, x, in pounds. And I want to write an equation to describe f of x as a piecewise defined function. It makes sense to use a piecewise defined function because there are two situations. The weight x could be exactly 1 pound, or it could be different from 1 pound. If the weight is exactly 1 pound, then f of x, the price, is 0. But if x is different from a pound, then the price is 10 times x. As a graph, my function's going to follow the line y equals 10x. But when x is exactly 1, my function's going to have a value of 0 and not 10. The open circle here represents a hole, or a place where a point is missing on the graph. Now, when x is near 1 but not equal to 1, then the f of x values, that is, the y values, are very close to 10. In the language of limits, we say that the limit, as x approaches 1, of f of x is equal to 10. More informally, we can write, as x approaches 1, f of x approaches 10. Notice that the value of f at 1 is actually equal to 0, not 10. And so the limit of f of x as x goes to 1 and the value of f at 1 are not equal. This illustrates the important fact that the limit here as x goes to 1 doesn't care about the value of f at 1. It only cares about the value of f when x is near 1. In general, for any function f of x, and for real numbers a and l, the limit as x goes to a of f of x equals l means that f of x gets arbitrarily close to l as x gets arbitrarily close to a. In other words, as x heads towards a, f of x heads towards l. Let me draw this as a picture. In this picture, I can say that the limit as x goes to a of f of x is l, because by taking a sufficiently small interval around a of x values, I can guarantee that my y values, my f of x values, lie in an arbitrarily small interval around l. Now the limit doesn't care about f's value at exactly a, so if I change the function, if I change the function's value at a, or even leave the function undefined at a, the limit is still l. But the limit does care about what happens for x values on both sides of a. If, for example, the function didn't even exist for x values bigger than a, then we could no longer say that the limit as x approached a was l. The limit would not exist. In other words, the limit of f of x is l only if the y values are approaching l as x approaches a from both the left and the right. For the function g of x graphed below, the limit as x goes to 2 of g of x does not exist because the y values approach 1 as the x values approach 2 from the left, and the y values approach 3 as the x values approach 2 from the right. Although the limit doesn't exist, we can say that the left-sided limit exists. And we write this as limit as x goes to 2 from the left of g of x is equal to 1. The superscript minus sign here means that x is going to 2 from the left side. In other words, the x values are less than 2 and approaching 2. Similarly, we can talk about right-sided limits. In this example, the limit as x goes to 2 from the right side of g of x is 3. And here, the superscript plus sign means that we're approaching 2 from the right side. In other words, our x values are greater than 2 and approaching 2. In general, the limit as x goes to a minus of f of x equals l means that f of x approaches l as x approaches a from the left, and the limit as x goes to a plus of f of x equals l means that f of x approaches l as x approaches a from the right. Limits from the left or from the right are also called one-sided limits. In this last example, let's look at the behavior of y equals h of x, graph below, when x is near negative 2. As x approaches negative 2 from the right, our y values are getting arbitrarily large, larger than any real number we might choose. We can write this in terms of limits by saying the limit as x goes to negative 2 from the right of h of x is equal to infinity. As x approaches negative 2 from the left, the y values are getting smaller. In fact, they go below any negative real number we might choose. In terms of limits, we can say that the limit as x goes to negative 2 from the left of h of x is negative infinity. In this example, the limit of h of x as x goes to negative 2, not specifying from the left or the right, means we have to approach negative 2 from both sides. And so this limit does not exist because the limits from the left and the limit from the right are heading in opposite directions. I want to mention that some people say that the limits from the right and the limits from the left also do not exist because the functions don't approach any finite number. I prefer to say that these limits do not exist as a finite number, but they do exist as infinity and negative infinity. This video introduced the idea of limits and one-sided limits and infinite limits.